Hi, I'm Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, and today—
Hey, I'm Jason Latimer.
But if you're Jason Latimer, who
Wait,
am I?
What?
Where have I seen this before?
That's right, Spider-Man, No Way Home, which is now available on Blu-ray and Digital. And because I too can relate to the intersection of science and magic, I want to see if we can come up with a way to create and shoot spiderwebs of our very own. First, I wanted to organically make spiderwebs shoot from my body, but radioactive spiders are hard to come by where I live, and in reality. But maybe, with a little bit of research, we can find out how spiderwebs are actually made. In my research, I found that when spiders moved from water to land, they evolved to make silk. Now, this was most likely due to the spiders wanting to protect their bodies and their eggs. Now, eventually, this silk would be used for hunting and became the spiral-like webs that we know today. You see, spiders produce silks from their spinneret glands, located at the tip of their abdomen. Now, most of these spinnerets are complex structures made from one or a group of spigots. And these spigots produce many kinds of silk, and some spiders are capable of producing up to 7 different silks during their lifetime.
All right, guys, focus on.
You see, spider silk is stretchy and strong as steel. Some people feel it can be used to make bulletproof vests, biodegradable water bottles, even bridge cables. Pretty much anything could be made out of spider silk.
Thanks, Jason.
Unfortunately, we don't know enough about the biological process of how to manufacture true spider silk in mass production.
Wait, hold on. My impossible science senses are tingling.
And they're saying that I'll be able to make a silky rope-like structure in under 30 seconds. Let's see if they're right.
Okay, here we go. First, I'm pouring 1,6-hexane diamine into a beaker and laying sublingual chloride on top. Now, the reaction between these two liquids creates a solid called nylon through a process called polymerization. Now, basically, polymerization happens when small molecules combine to produce a large chain-like molecule called a polymer. Uh-oh, I'm running out of time. Grabbing my hemostat scissors, I'm gonna slowly pull the nylon out of the container, and ta-da, we've created a spider web-like rope using chemistry. Now, as you can see, this is a lot of rope, and even though our nylon rope is awesome, this is just not as amazing as spider silk, or as cool as our friend Spider-Man, and how he's able to shoot webs. Which is why I'm gonna show you how to make a device that will allow you to sling webs, and it's made out of paper, cardboard, and other materials you can find around the house.
Wait a minute. Is that an Archimedean spiral? The mirror dimension is just geometry? You're great at geometry. You could do geometry.
To get started, print out the list of materials, template, and detailed instructions linked in the description below.
Now, let me show you how to build this. There is a lot to cover, but it's worth it.
Transfer the template to the cardboard and then cut out all the pieces. Next, roll the piece of paper around the spring, making sure it slides through the paper roll, creating the barrel. Secure it with super glue. Coat the outside with super glue and baking soda. Do this about 3 to 4 times to harden it up. Glue a plastic washer to the back of the barrel and harden it with super glue and baking soda. Then wrap the next piece around the barrel and glue it to complete the barrel. Take the dowel piece and glue your magnet to the end. Wrap a piece of tape around the magnet and the dowel and harden it with a layer of super glue and baking soda. Now slide the spring onto the dowel and glue the spring to the tape. Glue another magnet to the bottom of the dowel, completing the projectile.
Now, let's build this top mechanism.
Curl the outer portions of the wrist piece, leaving the middle flat. Curl this piece from the template and glue around the completed barrel.
Then we're gonna glue that here.
Glue the square piece to the back to complete the portion of the slinger. Now, glue this to the middle of the wrist piece. For the trigger, cut a jumbo popsicle stick to match the pieces from the template and glue to the corresponding cardboard pieces. Transfer the holes from the cardboard pieces to the wooden pieces. Tape these two pieces together to make a hinge. Make a small I-beam from the jumbo popsicle sticks and place them through the hole and glue. Next, trace your larger magnet shape onto this piece and cut away the cardboard and glue the magnet to the popsicle stick. Place a second magnet on the first and repeat to the opposite side, making sure to pay attention to the polarity of the magnet. Glue the circle piece to the end, completing the trigger. Glue the finished trigger to the bottom of the wrist piece, making sure it's positioned in front of the barrel with the I-beam, acting as a pin to hold the projectile.
And what you've really just made is this section right here. And that is your trigger, and this holds back the spring.
Cut out the pattern for the box that's used to hold the string that acts as the web. Now glue the extra rectangle piece to complete the box. Now attach the slinger using the small magnets.
Attach the string to it. And you put the string in a cartridge.
And now you've made your very own device that shoots webs. Paint it any color you like or get slinging right away. Just remember to consider safety goggles when you're dealing with projectiles. And now it's time for your friendly neighborhood science man to get some practice. Use your new creations to impress your friends or hunt down villains. But remember, with great power comes great responsibility. And if you want to learn more about spidey senses and intuition, or even superhuman reflexes and strength, click this video here.
So what are you guys doing after this? I'm a little hungry. I could eat.